Dark spots and yellow rings, telltale signs of fungal disease, spot form of net blotch, a constant threat to WA's barley, with most varieties susceptible to this disease.
Certainly you can see the disease levels just starting to move up through the canopy.
On Luke Hickey's farm at Corrigin, in the heart of WA's wheat belt, a disease control trial has been underway for a few years, overseen by Garen Nell.
This is mostly a fungicide trial, but we're also including other cultural practices, such as burning stubble. And one of the things that's shown over the 3 years of trials is that where we remove the stubble with the fire, we're getting a 400 kilo yield increase.
The Corrigin trial site has been chosen deliberately to test the potentially challenging medium rainfall zone, where tactics can be hard to pick.
In the high rainfall zone, where the yield potential is high and the disease pressure is high, it's really easy to make the spray decision. In the medium rainfall zone, because of variability, it's a harder decision on how many times and what strategy you should adopt.
In all zones, an integrated fungicide approach is recommended, especially as spot form net blotch resistance to older and cheaper fungicides has been reported on WA's south coast.
So growers need to manage their crop rotations in order to drop the disease pressure, and also rotate fungicides. So using the cheapest option all the time may well be more expensive in the future.
So we can see here, Lucas, some fairly high levels of spot type net blotch lower in the canopy, and you can see the importance of trying to keep the disease pressure lower on the top leaves. So this will be flag minus one. So when that leaf's fully open, that's the correct time to spray.
Garen says the cost of fungicide control, on average $6 to $15 a hectare, outweighs the potential loss of yield.
One cost is the cost of control, so applications and the chemical itself, and the other cost is lost yield. So it depends on where you are and what your yield potential is, but it's not uncommon in the high rainfall zone to lose up to half a tonne in yield, whereas in the lower rainfall zones it's more in the order of 1 to 200 kilos per hectare.
The four-year trial has a year left to run. Early results show reduced disease risks can be achieved by utilising different crop varieties, crop and fungicide rotations, and monitoring throughout the season.
Really, the key messages in the high rainfall zone is just to good management of your disease and keep the crops clean and have a really good crop rotation to drop your disease pressure. The medium rainfall zone, there's a lot of room for strategy and growers have to adapt their disease management according to the season. In the low rainfall zone, we're finding, or low rainfall years, the growers only require one fungicide, and that's best at the flag minus one stage, and it's an opportunity for growers to save costs and still grow a very good crop.
And if any grower in WA suspects the fungicide they've used has failed to control the disease, they're encouraged to send plant samples to Curtin University's Centre for Crop and Disease Management, which will test for any new case of fungicide resistance.